Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld. Thanks for watching. And today we're going to learn all about smart albums on your Mac. So let's go ahead and dive into smart albums on your Mac. So first and foremost, let's go ahead and look at the different ways to create a smart album. If we go up to the file menu within Photos, we can choose New Smart Album, or we can use the keyboard shortcut of Option, Command, and N on the keyboard. We can also come down on the left-hand side of our sidebar and located next to My Albums, there's a little plus sign that pops up. If we click on that, we have the ability to, again, create either an album, smart album, or folder. So if I create a smart album, it gives me a couple different choices to name the album once and then set different conditions and, let's say, rules of what it's actually going to put in this album. So just think of it like a very smart search. Based off of certain criteria, Photos is going to go find those pictures and put them in one spot for you. So let's say, for example, that you wanted to find every single photograph from your first iPhone. What's cool about that is in this list here, we can choose from a variety of different attributes or conditions. So album, date created, date added, description. But for this particular example, we want to do camera model. And we're gonna say it includes the words, or it does not include the words, or it is not. So just know that with every single criteria and category that you choose, there's always gonna be a subcategory of, yes, it includes this model, or no, it doesn't. So if we stick with the theory of, or the concept that we want to find every single photo that was taken with our very first iPhone, we could do camera model includes, and I'm just gonna start to type in iPhone. And when I do that, I'll start scrolling through the list here. I can see that within iPhone, I have iPhone 11, 3G, 3GS, and I think iPhone here, iPhone photos. iPhone is gonna be generic for all of them. So let's go ahead and do iPhone 3G. So 3G is from a long time ago. Quality has definitely improved. So I'm just gonna call this smart album iPhone 3G Photos. And what it's doing is it's matching the following conditions. The camera model includes iPhone 3G. Or actually what it should really be is the camera is iPhone 3G. That way for sure it's pulling in exactly that make and model of that photograph. So if I click OK, it now creates a new smart album on the left-hand side of my organization. And you can tell it's a smart album because it has that little gear there. And here I'm now able to see every single photo that was taken with my iPhone 3G. In the top left, you can see it was the date range from September 2009 to May 2010. There's 58 photos there that were taken. And yeah, so it's really nice for it to quickly filter out based off of that. Notice I have a few more smart albums here on the left. I did the same thing because I was curious about my Canon 5D that I used. So if I right click on this smart album, I can actually look at the option to edit the smart album. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So the same criteria is there. Camera model is, and then Canon EOS 5D Mark IV. So it's kind of nice to pull up every single, it'll see every single camera that that you have in your library. Because remember, every single time you take a picture with a digital camera, it creates what's called metadata. And that metadata is like a stamp that of information that tells that photograph what camera took it, did it have a flash, all of the settings, the resolution, pretty much everything about that photo is kind of baked in for you. So you'll notice I have lots of different camera models in here. Everything from GoPros to iPhones to Canon cameras, all sorts of stuff. So that's how this particular smart album is set up. And so here I can see from February to April 2020, I have all of the photos that were taken with my Canon 5D Mark IV. Now let's go ahead and create another example. We'll go back into Smart Album. And if we look through the criteria here, there's lots of possibilities. You want to quickly find very specific photos based off of the flash and the lens that was used, or just really any kind of very specific detail. This allows you to do that. Maybe the lens. I want to show every single lens that I took with. I have a very wide focal lens, a Sigma 14 millimeter. So here's a great example. I could say this is taken with my Sigma 14 millimeter camera. If I click OK, it's now going to go and find every single photograph that was taken with that particular lens that I have. And a wide angle is kind of like that fisheye almost. So it shows a very broad, a nice wide angle. And so you can see these are all the photographs that I took with that wide angle. Here in Israel, I had a picture so I can capture that whole seating in the background. So it's kind of nice to be able to quickly find those photographs. If we create another one, Smart Album, let's go ahead and back and look at it. File name, so if you name your photographs, you can quickly find them based off of the title, keywords. You know, maybe I use keywords for my photos, so I could say, find me every single photo that has the keyword aerial. And then this would be all of my drone pictures. So all drone aerial photos. And so now if I click OK, it's gonna go and find all of the pictures that I took with my various drones, or that I've tagged with aerial as that. And maybe I was on top of a building and I took a picture and then I tagged it aerial, even though it wasn't with my drone, that would also come in here. And we can do if you have questions about keywords, there's lots of different ways to add keywords to photos so that you can quickly find them other ways also. It's really nice when you're searching on your phone or within Photos here to quickly find those pictures. But keywords or smart albums, it can work in a variety of different ways. You can mix and match different photographs or different parameters. So let's say that I wanted to find every single photo that my son Bennett was in that was taken with my Canon 5D Mark IV. So I could say, the camera model is, and I'll filter out to say Canon 5D Mark IV, and then notice the little plus sign here. If I click on that, I can add a second parameter, and so then I could say, okay, the person is, and because I named the people in my photos, I can say is Bennett. Now the one thing that you want to change though is this match all of the following conditions or match any of the following conditions. So notice if I say match any of the following conditions, notice how many photos are there? Over 7,000 photos. But if I choose all, now it drops down to 302. So the importance of this is if I set it to any, it's automatically finding any photograph that's taken with that particular camera, but it's also finding any photograph that Bennett is in. But I don't want that. I want to find specifically photos that Bennett is in, but also that it's been taken with that Canon camera. So I need to say match all of these conditions and find me exactly that of what I'm looking for. And so that's why the number drops considerably, because it's only 302 versus 7,000. So I'm going to name my Smart Album and say Bennett Photos with 5D Mark IV, click OK, and now it's gonna go and find every single photograph that Bennett is in that was taken with that camera model. So it's kind of nice. It's just a really, really smart search that allows you to set different criterias so that you can find photos quickly, and photos will always be added into there. So the next time I take pictures of my son Bennett with that camera, it's gonna automatically bring those photographs into that Smart Album and save you that organization down the road. Now, a few differences between Smart Albums and regular albums. The biggest one is you can actually delete from Smart Albums. Now, you can delete from albums also, but the main difference is when you delete from a Smart Album, it's actually deleting it out of your entire iCloud or Photos library, which means it deletes off your phone, your iPad, any other Apple products that you have. Whereas when you delete it from an album, it's only removing it out of that custom organization of the album. The photo actually still resides in the Photos library. But just know that albums and smart albums, very, very similar with the organization, but there's definitely differences to them. So I'll take an example. Let's say that I take this picture and I press delete. Notice that it's actually gonna warn me and say delete from all of your devices. This item will be deleted from iCloud Photos on all of your devices. So if I click delete there, it's actually deleting it out of Photos. It's now removed it out of my phone, my iPad, my other Mac. So just know that if you're using Smart Albums a lot and you accidentally select a whole bunch that you didn't mean to delete, you're actually deleting them. Now, if I go to an album, so over here on the left-hand side, for example, I had this Apple Cabinet album, and if I select one of these photographs and I press delete, notice that it didn't give me any prompts to say, hey, you're deleting from all of your devices. It's only removing it from this album, this custom organization here. And if I right-click on here, I can actually say show in all photos, and this will take me to the Photos library. Notice how Apple Cabinet is no longer selected. It took me to Photos, and here is that picture that I removed from that album. So in album, the pictures still stay within the Photos library, but if you delete it out of a smart album, it's actually removing it out of everywhere. Now the other question that people often have is, well, if I create multiple smart albums in multiple albums, I don't want to duplicate the storage or the file sizes on my computer. I don't want to, you know, make 20 smart albums and then have, you know, those 20 pictures or 100 sub pictures be duplicated in every single one. But it doesn't work that way. All of the photos are just referenced to the main library. So you can make 100 different albums, you can make 100 different smart albums, but the pictures only reside in that photo library, in the main category, and then they're just referenced to them. So you don't have to worry about duplicating the storage on your computer. So if we go back and look at some other options for smart albums, so you know, you can do smart albums by an album, you can do it by date captured, date added, maybe you want to do a date range. So we could say date added in the last 30 days. So I want to see every single photo that I did in the last 30 days. So 30 days, or last 30 days we could call it. Last 30 days of photos. And we could say weeks, we could say months, we could say years. We could, you know, change this to say, is it in the range? So we could do a range of, you know, February 1st to December 12th, whatever it may be. So there's lots of different ways to use these smart albums, but it really comes down to, do you want to? It can be so detailed, but there's also other options within Photos that allow you to quickly find the pictures also. So let's stick with just the last, is in the last 30 days. So if we click OK here, it's now going to show me the photos literally from the last 30 days. So I took 1,700 photos, 42 videos, all within the last 30 days. If we look at some of the other choices, you can do it by descriptions, because you can add descriptions to your photos, you can add text to your photos as far as the title, not actually like text on top of your photos. You know, you can filter by person. Let's say I wanted to find every single photo that has both my sons in them. So I would say Bennett and click the plus sign, and I could say person is also, say Hudson. And again, either match any of those conditions or match all of the conditions. And so Bennett and Hudson, I'll click OK. And now it's gonna show me every single photograph with those two particular people in there. So you can see some of the ways that you can utilize smart albums to quickly find stuff and fine-tune your organization. The one thing I do wish it did was synchronize to your other devices. So if you do create smart albums, they do not synchronize as of right now. Hopefully they do, but they don't show up on your iPhone or your iPad. So Apple, if you're listening, please just let us sync the smart albums, because the albums do it, everything else does it, and it just, why not? Just do it. So that's smart albums in a nutshell. You can actually do quite a bit with it. It's just really up to your imagination of how you want to mix and match that search criteria. So again, my name is Joel Feld. If you liked what you saw and you enjoyed learning, go ahead and click that subscribe and click that little bell. And if you have any comments, questions, go ahead and leave those in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.